Okay, at least for this first bit, there's quite a lot of me just talking you through basically slideshows of photos that I took on my trip to Charleston in South Carolina and Savannah in Georgia. Let's go. Okie dokie, on Sunday of last week we just drove down to South Carolina. It was about a 3-4 hour drive, so we just spent the whole day doing that, and we stayed in this super cute little tiny house. I've decided I don't want to have a big house ever. I would be quite happy living in this tiny little house. It had a bridge in it, which is so cool. You could make one of the bedrooms an office, and then what do you need a big house for? As long as you have a living room, a kitchen, and somewhere to sleep and somewhere to work, you're good. We were staying in this really cute town called Somerville, which is a really nice name, and they had Christmas decorations, and the Airbnb that we stayed in was cool. They had one that was set up like a boat. And then we went into Charleston for the day on Monday. So we got brunch at a really nice place and went to the Christmas market in Charleston. And everywhere had loads of Christmas decorations. All of the buildings were really old and nice architecture and well designed. And there were horse and cart carriages going around. So it did feel quite touristy, and I'll give you my full thoughts on the city later. But I liked it. It was nice to see some old buildings, but it wasn't my favorite city ever. It's definitely not somewhere that I really feel the need to go back to, and it's not somewhere that I'd ever really live. We did go to see the coast in Charleston, and then we headed to our next Airbnb for the night, which was a remodeled bus. There was a super friendly cat that we did let into the bus eventually, and it was super friendly and super cozy, and this was the bus that we stayed in. It was really cool. I just love finding like little unique Airbnb places like this. Here's the inside of the bus. It was very warm and very cozy. And it's just so cool. It just makes it so much more memorable. The roads all looked really like this. It was raining pretty much. It wasn't raining the whole time we were there, but it was quite grey a lot of the time we were there. But the trees were really cool, how they kind of bend over the road and make it feel like you're going through a tunnel. And then the next day, after our stay in the bus, we drove down to Savannah in Georgia. Savannah was really nice. It felt very British for some reason. Maybe that's just because it was like grey and rainy, but we both said that it felt like a British high street rather than any American high streets that we've seen. And it's made up of all these like really small islands that you have to go over bridges to go onto. So that was cool to drive across and see. Then to our next Airbnb, which had a treehouse and a swing. It's so cool. I can't believe that Airbnb just works and lets you stay in random people's houses. This house was really cool. I need to find a different word than cool, but everything's been really cool. But they had a slightly unsettling clown theme inside. And this is just like some roadside shops that we found on our drives, and the treehouse again. Yeah, there was this really weird like clown theme and stuff everywhere in the house. So it was cool, but slightly murder vibes. We went to a sports bar for dinner, and there was like an online pub quiz. This is us getting lost at a police station, and that's the Airbnb from the outside. It's really nice buildings, and you can kind of get a sense for how South Carolina and Georgian architecture differs from North Carolina architecture, because Georgia and South Carolina got so much more rich through the slave trade than North Carolina ever did. Here are some of my thoughts on Charleston in South Carolina and Savannah in Georgia. Charleston was pretty and nice, but a little bit underwhelming. So many people, again, had told me, you'll love Charleston, it's really historical, it's really pretty, it's really nice. But compared to other American cities, yes, it was. But compared to European cities, it doesn't even compare. It felt like, you know, Edinburgh has old buildings and history just as a part of it. It feels like a real functioning city. It's obviously like there's some tourist areas, but the buildings are just old and that's how the city is. Charleston felt like it had been purposely preserved as old buildings. It didn't feel like a functional city. It felt almost like a living history entire city. So even though it's really nice and really pretty and the Christmas market was nice, it just felt inauthentic in a way that European cities don't, because they just have so much history and culture woven into the city as it's become a modern city, if that makes any sense. I think it also probably didn't help that it was like grey and rainy the days that we were there, so I didn't feel like, oh my god, it's sunny and it's warm and it's really nice. But still, it was nice. A bit underwhelming. Savannah was nicer than Charleston. I really liked Savannah's streets and houses and buildings. But I don't know, I liked all of the islands around it. I haven't found my perfect American city yet. San Francisco was very close, but I'm still on the lookout. I have high hopes for DC, and I have high hopes for Boston whenever I end up going to Boston.
The drive there and back was really fun. There were all these like random billboards, which I'll insert pictures of. And I wish I had got pictures of them, but we were driving back up from Savannah, we were in South Carolina, and there were three billboards right next to each other. The first one was an anti-abortion billboard. The second one was a Jesus loves you, read the Bible billboard. And the third one was a stop socialism, vote Trump 2020 billboard. And just the absolute American vibes that were captured driving along a highway and seeing those billboards. It's just so strange. We stopped at this really cool service station just below the North Carolina-South Carolina border, which was set up like, I think it was like Mexican themed, like south of the border theme. And overall, I'm really glad that we went to Charleston and Savannah. I'm really glad that we've seen them, and I can tick South Carolina and Georgia off my list, but they're not places that I'd live. Nice coastal sides, nice lots of little islands. Shame it wasn't sunny. Not my favourite places ever, but worth a visit if you're in the area.
Something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined, and now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
She glanced this way, I thought I saw. When we touched, she didn't shudder at my paw. No, it can't be. I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me that way before.
And then we drove back to Raleigh on Boxing Day, and I brought this jacket as a Christmas present to myself.
Christmas actually ended up being such a lovely time. Me and Sarah watched tons of Disney movies. We made a pretty decent Christmas dinner, considering we forgot to defrost the chicken until the morning of, and we were using plug-in appliances, and we had like one baking tray and one pan to use, and like the very basics were in that bus. We managed to make a decent Christmas dinner out of it that actually tasted really good. And I was like calling my parents a couple of times throughout the day, my brother, my grandparents, and I thought that having Christmas by myself for the first time on like a converted school bus in the middle of nowhere with someone that I met for the first time a few months ago would be a little bit depressing. I thought like we'd make the best of it and it would be nice, but there'd be a little bit of a depressing tinge about it, but it wasn't at all. I genuinely had so much fun, and it was such a memorable Christmas and such a nice way to spend my first Christmas away from my family. It was really nice, and we like decorated the cabin, and it was just such a fun Christmas. It wasn't like super fun, we didn't do anything crazy, but it was definitely memorable, and I'm glad that I got to experience it and to live in America and experience Christmas in America here. It was much better than I thought it would be, exceeded all of my expectations, and was so warm and cozy. And also it was 21 degrees on Christmas Day, so beat that, Scotland. I think that's all for this week. A lot's gone on. I keep forgetting that Charleston and Savannah is in this week as well. And a lot's going on next week. It's my birthday, it's New Year's Eve, and I'm going to Washington DC today when I'm filming this. And then also a random cabin that one of my friends' families are going to for New Year's. So lots coming up, lots has happened, and the new term is sneaking up on us super fast. See you in the next one. Bye.